This video was made in collaboration with Narutopedia. For more information, check out the link in the description. The Life of Kakuzu from Naruto. Kakuzu was an S-rank missing nin from Takigakure and a member of Akatsuki who was partnered with Hidan. Kisame Hoshigaki jokingly referred to them as the zombie combo, due to the fact that in differing senses, they could not die. Welcome to the Imagi. In today's video, we're going over the life of Kakuzu. Before we begin, we publish a new video every day, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. Background. When under the servitude of Takigakure as an elite ninja, Kakuzu took on a mission to assassinate Hashirama Senju, the first Hokage. The mission, however, ended in failure against the god of shinobi. Despite the insurmountable danger faced on the mission, what awaited his return to the village was the stigma and harsh punishment associated with the failure of his objective. In response to this treatment, a wrong levied against a shinobi who had put life and limb on the line for his village, Kakuzu came to hold a violent hatred for Takigakure as he escaped from imprisonment. In his flight from the village, Kakuzu killed the village elders, took their hearts, and fled with knowledge of the village's most prized forbidden techniques. He made a living off bounty hunting on the black market, and tearing out the still beating hearts of powerful shinobi to extend his own lifespan and arsenal. At some point in the past, he apparently encountered the Gold and Silver Brothers, and witnessed Kinkaku's Jinchuriki transformation. Sometime after his defection, he became affiliated with, and joined, the criminal organization Akatsuki. During his early years in Akatsuki, he had four partners that he eventually ended up killing due to his short temper, and would use their hearts for his earth grudge fear. Eventually, he found a new partner, Hidan, who was convinced to join, taking an interest in Kakuzu, thinking of him as a pioneer of immortality. This made Hidan a fitting partner for Kakuzu as he could not be killed because of his own, similar immortality despite their mutual dislike of each other. Sasuke Recovery Mission. At the end of Part 1, Kakuzu made a cameo appearance as a silhouette during an Akatsuki gathering where they discussed Orochimaru's taking of Sasuke Uchiha, as well as the capturing of the Ninetales and the furthering of their plans. The Fallen Castle. In the anime, Kakuzu and Hidan met with Sasori and Deidara to discuss their new missions assigned by Akatsuki. After Kakuzu said they had a choice between a money-making mission and a war mission, he chose the money mission after Sasori and Deidara showed no interest in it, much to Hidan's annoyance. In Naruto's Footsteps, The Friends' Paths. In the anime, the duo was sent to capture the Jinchuriki, Fu. Fu was excited to befriend a fellow Taki comrade, despite knowing the rogue shinobi's history. However, Kakuzu states that their motives aren't to become friends with her. Kazekage Rescue Mission. Kakuzu is present alongside the other Akatsuki members, stealing Shukaku. Sometime afterwards, he reattached Deidara's arms. Akatsuki Suppression Mission. Kakuzu first appeared with his partner Hidan in their pursuit of the Two-Tails Jinchuriki, Yugito Ni, who revealed that she allowed herself to be cornered in order to spring a trap on them and eliminate them herself. Yugito then transformed into her tailed beast, a large flaming cat, but the Akatsuki duo still managed to defeat her and gave her to Zetsu before they continued to the Land of Fire. On their way, Kakuzu decided to attack the Fire Temple in order to collect the bounty on the head monk, Chiriku, who is listed in the bingo book with a 30 million ryo bounty. They slaughtered most of the other monks during the event, but one escaped to warn Konoha of the incoming threat. Upon receiving the notice, Tsunade assigned the Niju Shotai to track down and eliminate Kakuzu and Hidan. Meanwhile, Kakuzu took Chiriku's body to a bounty station hidden in a bathroom, while Hidan chose to wait outside. When Kakuzu finally left the bathroom after counting the money, he found a Niju Shotai team, led by Asuma Sarutobi, attacking Hidan. He attacked Shikamaru Nara in order to free Hidan, but was forbidden from further participation in the battle by the overconfident Hidan himself. Kakuzu complied, but insisted that he would get to have the 35 million ryo head of Asuma afterwards. In the ensuing battle, Hidan managed to ingest Asuma's blood to start his curse technique ceremony on him, but Shikamaru was able to stop him with his shadow imitation technique. When Asuma managed to decapitate Hidan, Kakuzu finally intervened and reattached Hidan's head back to his neck using the threads in his body. Kakuzu then fought with Kotetsu and Izumo, easily holding the two off, while Hidan dealt a fatal blow to Asuma. Their battle was interrupted by the appearance of another Niju Shotai team, but they easily fought them off until they were summoned by the Akatsuki leader to seal the Two Tails. Hidan and Kakuzu retreated to a secluded area where they spent 3 days sealing the Two Tails, and in the manga, another 3 days sealing the Three Tails. After the sealing was complete, Kakuzu and Hidan set out on their mission for the Nine-Tailed Demon Fox's Jinchuriki, Naruto Uzumaki, only to be cut off by Team Asuma, with Kakashi Hatake as the leader in place of Asuma. Shikamaru used Asuma's chakra knives to capture both the Akatsuki members in place with a trick, but Kakuzu had discovered the trick beforehand, and using a separate arm, broke free. Because of his ability to harden his skin, Kakuzu proved to be largely invulnerable to subsequent attacks. Kakashi, however, was able to analyze Kakuzu's hand seals and pierced Kakuzu's heart with his lightning cutter, exploiting the weakness Kakuzu's earth-based technique had against lightning-based ones. While this would normally be fatal, Kakuzu had 5 hearts, now 4, in his possession, and thus recovered fairly quickly, sending a counterattack to Kakashi. Removing his cloak, he revealed 4 masks on his back, one of which was now broken by Kakashi. Each mask contained a heart, the broken one having given its heart up to keep Kakuzu alive. The 4 masks broke free from his back into separate entities, with the broken one dissolving after doing so. Each mask was able to attack with a specific and powerful elemental attack, making Kakuzu almost too much for Team 10 to handle. While Kakuzu set his sights on replacing his lost heart with Kakashi's, Shikamaru dragged Hidan away from the battlefield into some woods with his shadow imitation technique for a one-on-one fight. Ignoring the other two for the most part, Kakuzu focused on taking Kakashi's heart. Though Kakashi was unable to handle Kakuzu and his mask creatures, being forced to protect Ino and Choji too, he was saved when Shikamaru tricked Hidan into using some of Kakuzu's blood in his curse ritual, which Kakashi had collected in a capsule earlier when he pierced Kakuzu's chest and handed it over to Shikamaru. This resulted in Hidan unintentionally destroying Kakuzu's main body's heart. Seeing this, the lightning mask allowed its heart to be absorbed by Kakuzu's body, bringing him back to life. In addition to that, Kakuzu also had the 2 other fire and wind masks to combine with him, making him even more powerful. He then caught the rest of Team 10 with his threads, hoping to replenish his stock. Team 10 was saved by the arrival of Team 7, among them being Naruto, who decided to fight Kakuzu himself, who at first did not view Naruto as a threat. This changed when Naruto unveiled his newly developed technique, Wind Release, Rasen Shuriken, which Kakuzu recognized to be dangerous if it ever connected with him. Naruto's inability to maintain the technique for more than a few seconds put Kakuzu at ease, especially since its failure almost allowed him to kill Naruto, though Yamato and Kakashi saved him, but decided to fight in his long range mode just to be safe. As Naruto tried the Rasen Shuriken once again with his shadow clones, Kakuzu attempted to crush Naruto with his threads from a distance, but was surprised to discover that it was a shadow clone that he had destroyed, and subsequently, the real Naruto shot up behind him, using the technique effectively this time. Left with no usable hearts after being battered by Naruto's technique, Kakuzu lamented being defeated by those he considered kids. Kakashi assured him that the previous generation being surpassed by the next was perfectly natural, and one of the never-ending cycles of life. Kakashi then finished him off with a lightning cutter. Kakuzu's corpse was later taken back to Konoha to be autopsied by Tsunade in regards of the Rasen Shuriken's capabilities, and it was revealed that Kakuzu was damaged at a cellular level by it. Power. In the anime, Kakuzu is summoned by Kabuto to battle Team Kakashi, who are investigating the massacre that he brought about in the hole. Quickly after being summoned, Kakuzu's coffin vanishes with Kabuto questioning if the impure world reincarnation is incomplete. Fourth Shinobi World War, countdown. In an attempt to both impede Tobi and coerce him into joining forces during their initial encounter, Kabuto Yakushi demonstrated his capabilities by reincarnating many of the deceased members of Akatsuki, including Kakuzu, using summoning Impure World Reincarnation. Fourth Shinobi World War, confrontation. Mobilizing alongside Itachi as the Fourth Shinobi World War against the allied Shinobi forces commences, Kakuzu carries the immobile Nagato on his back. Separating from these two whilst relocating to the Land of Lightning's coast, Kakuzu emerges from the sea amongst the White Zetsu army, engaging the opposing 1st Division while strangling multiple shinobi in its threads. Soon after, Kakuzu glances over at Kinkaku's transformation, noting that he hadn't seen it in a very long time. Confronted by the current generation Ino Shikacho, he discerns from Shikamaru's presence that Hidan had likely been decapitated but still alive, as he wasn't among the reincarnated. Obtaining his 5th and final heart, Kakuzu proceeds to unleash his masks to fulfill his role as a bishop. He then remarks that even though the Gold and Silver Brothers were captured, they ironically already possessed the gold and silver pieces from the opposing side, meaning Dankato and Asuma respectively. Just as his masks disperse, Kakuzu's arms are sliced off by Izumo and Kotetsu before being bound in their chains, as he stated that he tends to forget people over whom he can't collect bounties. Escaping his captors as they pursue him, Kakuzu's lightning heart is destroyed by Tenten through the use of the Bashōsen. Whilst later fighting Darui, Izumo, and Kotetsu, he was shocked to see Choji's butterfly wings overshadowing the battlefield. With his masks defeated, Kakuzu is eventually restrained beneath Choji's giant fist. But when the latter departs to stop the demonic statue of the Outer Path's rampage, the others are left to bind Kakuzu. Fourth Shinobi World War, climax. With the cancelling of the Impure World Reincarnation Technique, Kakuzu's soul was released back to the afterlife. Personality. Kakuzu was a greedy and miserly individual. He would arrange goals in terms of the highest profit he could gain from them, and was often unwilling to involve himself in something if there was nothing to gain from it, as well as claiming that he tended to forget opponents who were not worth any money after he was done with them. He even remarked that money is the only dependable thing in the world. To this end, he referred to himself as the treasurer of Akatsuki. Given his friendly relationship with Zange, his bounty officer, it would seem he collected bounties rather frequently to earn cash, and did so, or at least tried, during missions on several occasions. The frequent side tasks and devotion to money were both major points of contention between Hidan and Kakuzu. He also seemed to respect an opponent who thinks well, as shown with his reaction to Kakashi's counters to Kakuzu's masks, and Shikamaru's quick analysis of Hidan's curse, even mentioning Shikamaru would have been a good bounty in the future. Out of all the Akatsuki members, Hidan and Kakuzu displayed the most animosity towards each other, since neither of them were very fond of each other's interests. The two often traded barbs with one another, Kakuzu's usually having better timing than Hidan's. Hidan had showed great annoyance with Kakuzu's greed and occasional habit of doing or saying blasphemous things, such as attacking a temple and killing the head monk for the bounty on the monk's head. Kakuzu, in turn, disliked Hidan's religion, believing the rituals associated with it to be a waste of time. Kakuzu was also rather impatient with Hidan's drawn-out speeches and battle style. Despite their mutual dislike of each other, their teamwork was almost flawless because they complemented each other's abilities extremely well. Also, Kakuzu seems to care to an extent about Hidan, as he picked up and gave back his partner's forehead protector after he lost it during his fight with Asuma, a feat that made Hidan admit that Kakuzu is not as hostile as he appeared to be, although Kakuzu did note that he only did so because he could not stand the sight of the scar on Hidan's neck. The only reason that Kakuzu put up with Hidan was because he couldn't get rid of him. Due to his violent temper, Kakuzu often killed anyone close by when enraged, having killed his previous partners and even took their hearts to extend his own life. Hidan, therefore, was the perfect partner for Kakuzu, because of Hidan's inability to die. Kakuzu's somewhat indiscriminate attack style also made Hidan an ideal partner, since Kakuzu didn't need to worry about catching his partner in the crossfire. Despite his obsessive personality and violent rages, Kakuzu was much more cautious than his partner, and was not as arrogant, never mindlessly rushing into battle like Hidan. Kakuzu frequently warned Hidan not to let his guard down, and then teased Hidan when he inevitably did. Kakuzu also seemed quite willing to follow orders. When ordered to retreat by the Akatsuki leader, Kakuzu complied immediately, while Hidan attempted to argue, despite the rather large bounty he would have received by taking Asuma. He seemed to forget the greater goals of the organization when in rage, as he attempted to kill Naruto in spite of Akatsuki's need to capture all the Jinchuriki alive. Kakuzu held a violent hatred for his village, as despite his loyalty and willingness to risk life and limb on a dangerous mission, his failure was repaid with uncharacteristically harsh punishment. He responded in kind by brutally betraying Takigakure, committing jailbreak, taking knowledge of their most valuable kenjutsu, and killing all the elders before departing. Did you enjoy our video? Be sure to check out these other great videos from the Amagi, and make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.